Next one is the piston motor. So we have already discussed what is the piston and cylinder arrangement. A piston can reciprocate because you are supplying the high pressure hydraulic fluid. Now it is possible to ensure that we can use the same piston and cylinder arrangement, but of a very, very small size, and we are able to get a continuous rotary motion. So if you are using the pistons to get a rotary motor motion, then it is called as a piston motor. So the pistons are simply reciprocating, but because of the arrangements made, it is possible to ensure that the output shaft is having a rotary movement. So we can call it as a rotary actuator. So how does the piston rotate? So now you are having a cylinder block here. The cylinder block will be having multiple holes, maybe 9 holes, 7 holes, or maybe 11 number of holes. In each of these holes, you will be having a piston which can it can reciprocate up and down. In this direction, the piston can reciprocate. Now the end of the piston rod is pressed against an inclined surface. It is pressed against an inclined surface, and you are having a piston shoe here in order to reduce the friction. Now this entire cylinder block can rotate. So along with the cylinder block, the pistons can also rotate inside the cylinder block. Now what happens when the piston is applying a force like in the right direction here according to the figure? So this is the inlet port and this will be the outlet port here. And if you are supplying fluid here, then the fluid is entering into the cavity and the piston is pushed outward and it is applying force on the inclined surface. So whenever you are applying a force on the inclined surface, the forces will be resolved perpendicular to the surface and along the surface. So whatever force is generated along the surface, that will cause the piston slide down. This force which is causing the piston to slide down is what is the force that is trying to rotate the cylinder block. So when the piston is trying to slide down, since it is present inside the cylinder block will try to rotate. Since there are multiple pistons inside the cylinder block, so continuously one cylinder after another cylinder is trying to slide down, or it is trying to generate force tangential to the inclined surface. Thereby, they are one piston will be sliding downwards, another will be sliding upwards. So you are having a continuous rotation. So the rotation is caused because the force of the piston, whatever is coming outward, it is creating a tangential force to this particular surface. That tangential force will cause the piston to either slide downwards or to slide upwards. Since the piston cannot move on its own, it can only have a reciprocatory motion. As it is trying to slide down, the cylinder block is going to have a rotary movement to ensure that the piston can have some motion and the pressure is relieved. So in this way, the torque is generated continuously. So this is the cylinder block. Here you will be having a port plate. You will be having something called as a port plate. You will be having an inlet port which will be in the elliptical shape. You will be having an outlet port. Again, that will also be in the elliptical shape. So simultaneously, high pressure fluid is entering into several pistons, and the whatever oil is there here, that is escaping out into the outlet port. So over several pistons, maybe 3 or 4 pistons are covered simultaneously through the outlet port. 3 or 4 pistons are simultaneously covered through the inlet port, and you are having the continuous motion. Now what happens if this inclined surface is perpendicular to the axis? If the inclined surface is perpendicular to the axis, if you are supplying the high pressure fluid here, the piston will come outward and it is trying to push the flat surface backwards. Then there will not be any motion generated because there is no tangential component, or there is no component of force along the surface of the plate. There is only force which is perpendicular to the surface of the plate. So there will not be any motion possible. There is not be any rotary motion possible. So if the angle is more, the stroke length of the piston also will be more. If the angle is less, then the stroke length of the piston also will be very, very less. So if you want more force, then you have to increase the angle. If you want less force, you have to reduce the angle. The angle is less. What happens is you are having the upper end, you are having the lower end, that is the stroke length. So for a very small stroke length, the piston can make a half rotation during the power movement. So as it is extending, for a small movement, it can make a half rotation. If the stroke length is large, for a larger movement, it can make a half rotation. And if you are supplying the hydraulic pressure at a fluid at a constant pressure, then what happens? For a small movement here, it can complete the
of a rotation. So when this angle is less, you will have higher speed, and when this angle is more, you will be having lower speed. So but when the speed is less, usually the power or torque generated will be on the higher end. So the figure shows here the fixed cam plate design. Now why it is called axial piston motor? It is called axial piston motor because this is the axis of the output shaft, that is the drive shaft. Then the piston axis is parallel to the axis. That is why it is called as axial piston motor, and you are having a fixed swash plate. So it is a swash plate piston motor. Now you can have the drive piston shaft on one side, or you can have the piston on the other side. Both the designs are possible. So if you are having the drive shaft on the other side, then this swash plate is there. It will be having a cavity in the middle, and through that cavity, the drive shaft is going to be taken out. So both the designs are available. So the next one is bent axis piston motor. Now you can see here, you are having the pistons which is reciprocating inside the cylinder block. The cylinder block along with the output shaft will be rotating around their axis. You are having the drive shaft which is at an angle. So this is the axis of the cylinder block or axis of the pistons. This is the axis of the drive shaft. They are at an angle. The main thing we have to remember is, you can see here, this surface of the drive shaft is what is the surface on which the pistons are able to slide, thereby creating the rotary movement. That is the important thing to remember here. So the pistons can slide on top of this particular surface. The power is transmitted because there is a universal joint which is a very strong one and which can supply the torque from the cylinder block to the output shaft. So when you are supplying, this is the inlet and you are having the outlet. When you are supplying high pressure fluid on the inlet, the piston is pushed outward, but the piston cannot move straight because it is applying force on the inclined surface, and you are having a normal force and you are having the tangential force to the surface. This tangential force causes the piston along with the cylinder block to rotate. So this rotation is transferred by the universal joint from the cylinder block to the output shaft, and the output shaft will rotate about its axis. Simultaneously, the cylinder block also will be having the rotation. Now, what is the advantage of this particular system? See here the angle. The angle is controlled by the position of this particular drive shaft. If you are trying to pull the drive shaft outward, this angle is going to change. This angle is simply going to change. So controlling the output will be much easier in case of the bent axis piston motor as compared to the swash plate type of piston motor. Now what is the disadvantage? Disadvantage is you are having more elements. You are having a universal joint which has to be connected to the piston motor and also to the drive axis shaft. So because of the additional elements, so this system is comparatively more costlier as compared to the regular one. Also because the axes are completely different, the arrangement in the machine or the system, it has to be properly designed. Otherwise, you may be having space in this direction, but your actual design at an angle, so which may not be possible. Bent axis will provide the inclined surface on which the piston cylinder pistons can slide. Because of the pistons cannot naturally slide, so the cylinder block will rotate along with the piston as they are sliding downwards because of the action of the high pressure fluid. The main advantage of piston motors is they can generate very, very high torques within a very small size. Of all the things, they can generate the maximum amount of torque, and they can also operate at significantly high speed. So both the things are possible. The main disadvantage is their initial cost is very, very high as compared to the other hydraulic actuators. So that is why their use is used only where you want very high power and torque requirements, you are going for the piston motors. Next one is the radial piston motor. In the radial piston motor, you are having the piston which is reciprocating inside. So you are having the inlet port, you are having the outlet port. So whenever the high pressure fluid or the high pressure compressed air is entering here, the pistons are pushed outward. So when the pistons are pushed outward, again the forces will be tangential to the inner surface and they will be perpendicular to the inner surface. Because of the tangential component of the force, this cylinder block will try to rotate. When the cylinder block tries to rotate, the drive shaft connected to the cylinder block, that also will rotate, and a rotary motion is generated. So here the fluid is not present here. The fluid is present only on this position. So this will be the cylinder. So they will be round-shaped pistons. And for motion of the piston is in the radial direction with respect to the axis of the motor, it is called as a radial piston motor. So on a cylinder block, you will be having usually odd number of pistons, and you are having the inlet and outlet port present at the center. So fluid is coming here. It is acting on different pistons. The pistons are moving outward because of the tangential component of the force along the inner surface of the casing. The pistons are trying to move like that. Along with the piston, the cylinder block will rotate. Along with the cylinder block, you are having the drive shaft which is rotating. So what is the advantage? Now already I said that the piston motors can generate lot of torque. Among the piston motors, radial piston motor can generate the maximum amount of torque. The speed of operation is moderate, but the torque developed is the maximum. So you'll be having odd number of pistons drilled into the cylinder rotor or the cylinder block here. Turbine motor is a kind of pneumatic motor in which instead of having vanes or something, you will be having something called as a turbine. This turbine is very similar to your Pelton wheel and other turbines you are using in the fluids, in the water power generation and other places. It is more or less the same. So the high pressure air is going to enter into the turbine casing, and it is impacting against the vanes of the turbine or the blades of the turbine. Because of this impact, the energy of the air is getting transferred to the turbine blades, and from because the turbine blades are mounted on the rotor, the turbine is going to rotate, and thereby you are going to get the rotary motion. Now what is the advantage of this turbine motor? The main advantage of turbine motor is you can generate very very high speed. That is one of the main advantages of the turbine motor. Now where is its application? Its main application was found in the dental drilling. So if you are going to a dentist and he is doing the drilling of your teeth, that drill is run by using the turbine motor, because you require very high speed and you want to remove very small amount of material. So there you are using the turbine motors. Apart from that, you can also use it for doing some grinding activity where some high speed is required. You can use a turbine motor. Disadvantage of this one is the efficiency. It is having a slightly lower efficiency as compared to the piston motors, gear motors and other elements. The advantage is you can get the maximum amount of speed using the turbine motor. The next one type of rotary actuators is limited rotation rotary actuator. So limited rotation means the output shaft may not continuously rotate forever. It will be having some particular angle for which it can rotate in one direction, and then it has to rotate in the opposite direction. So like that, the output will be there. So what are the different configurations? Here you are having the three configurations shown here. First one, you will be having a cylinder. Inside the cylinder, you are having the piston. On the piston surface, you are having teeth, rack and pinion teeth. No, that rack teeth are cut on the piston, and the output shaft is connected to a gear here. Output shaft is connected to the gear. Now, how does this operate? So when you are supplying high pressure fluid here, the piston will try to move forward. But when the piston is trying to move forward, whatever the teeth that are cut on its underside, since they are meshing with the gear here, when the piston is moving forward, the gear is going to rotate. Depending on the number of teeth present on the piston and the movement of the piston, the gear can rotate one times or one and a half times or even for a small angle. So that is all dependent on the size of the piston, number of teeth present on the piston. Again, when you are supplying the fluid here, the piston is going to return back. So when it is moving backwards, it is going to rotate the gear. So in another configuration, you are having the vane motor. Here you are having a stopper. Inside you are having a stopper, and you are having only one vane, or you can have two vanes here as shown in the figure. So in this configuration, what will happen? So you are having two ports, port A and port B. The two ports are separated by using a stopper block here, and then the rotor shaft is sealing the stopper block here so that air cannot escape straight away from side A onto the side B. Then you are having the vane. Now if you are supplying high pressure air at B or high pressure fluid at B, it will act on this surface. It is acting on this particular surface of the vane, and it is going to rotate up to this particular point. When it reaches, it will be stopped from further movement. Then you change over the direction of supply air. You supply the air to A. What happens again? It is going to rotate in the other direction, and it will stop over here. So in this configuration, you can get a maximum angle of 300 degrees in the single vane design. Now you'll see double vane design. So double vane design means you are having two vanes. You will be having multiple inlet ports and you will be having multiple outlet ports. Then if you are supplying high pressure air here, you can see the connections are different. This is the inlet port and another inlet port is over here, so that the shaft can rotate in the same direction. If you are making the two here inlets and the two here outlets, what will happen? Now we'll see. If you are supplying air at both the directions, compressor is coming here or high pressure fluid is coming here, high pressure fluid will come here. They are acting in this direction. They are acting in this direction. The shaft cannot rotate because the two forces are balancing and there will not be any rotation possible. So you have to be very careful about the connections. One connection here, another connection over there. Other set of ports are connected here and connected over here. Now if you are supplying high pressure air at A, then what will happen? The fluid will come here. It is acting in this region and it is acting in this region. So when the fluid is acting in this region, what will happen? This particular vane is pushed in this direction. This particular vane is pushed in the other direction. So you will be having a couple because of which the rotor is going to rotate. If you are supplying in the fluid at a B port, then it will be having the rotation in the opposite direction. Now, what is the difference between single vane design and double vane design? So in a single vane design, you are having only one vane. So whatever surface of the vane is there, multiplied by the pressure, you are going to get the force. But in case of the double vane design, you are having two vanes. So the area on which the compressed fluid or pressurized fluid is acting is more. So it can develop more torque as compared to the single vane design. But what is the disadvantage of double vane design? Since there are two stoppers here, the angle of rotation is less than 150 degrees. Because the stopper itself will occupy a certain space inside. So it can rotate from this position to this position only. So it will be around 150 degrees is what is the rotation in one direction. Then it has to rotate backwards. So that is about the vane motor configuration. Then you are having the piston type rotary actuator. Here you are having two pistons.
The connecting rod of two pistons are connected to your lever arm below the pistons as shown. When we apply high pressure on piston A, the piston will move down and simultaneously the piston B is going to move upwards. So you are going to have some rotation at the center of the lever arm or at the crank. When we apply the high pressure at B, then the piston B is going to move down and piston A is going to move upwards. So by this way, by alternating the high pressure fluid supply to port A or port B, we are able to make the corresponding pistons move upward or downward, thereby getting a twisting motion at the center of the lever arm or at the center of the crank. So this is a simple method of achieving a limited rotation using a piston and cylinder arrangement.